So I am asking you tonight to do what your predecessors have done, to change the laws, to change the community and the feeling of the community, and to make Schenectady a sanctuary city. I strongly urge and encourage all of you to continue the dialogue, to open up the dialogue for public discussion, and to consider making Schenectady a sanctuary city. Thank you.
We need to have Schenectady as a sanctuary town. We all want to work together. This is what Martin Luther King wanted.
I'm sorry. Illegal is illegal. I don't care what anyone says.
My idea of a sanctuary city was initially came forward as a safety issue. A sanctuary city status would be a slap in the face with this process.
You people, this is the truth! No sanctuary!
It goes on and on and on.
Good evening, Mr. Mayor, City Council, Madam President. I'll get right to the point. 2 weeks ago, I came here and mainly speaking on what came to light of a code enforcement officer and my thoughts on why Council didn't show up at the services for Ms. Gonzalez. Unlike my fellow residents, 2 weeks ago, my name forced this Council Mayor to make this sanctuary city. He did not list the reason why he believes should or should not be. So I guess I'm going to be the voice of common sense here. These are the reasons why I and a lot of others believe that this should not, cannot, will not be a sanctuary city. We're talking two aspects of the law and safety. One, the law. In these sanctuary cities, we've got people coming into the city. Now don't get me wrong, city or the nation. I'm not talking about people coming into the nation with proper paperwork, making contributions. I'm for that. What I'm against is criminals, known criminals worldwide, with routes 2 to 3 miles long, paying authority figures under the table. They killed one of us, innocent American. See, this is that one aspect of the law. They go through our justice system, city judge. Go right back out, don't even see it inside of jail. Go out, killing us innocent Americans. The second aspect of the law is that these nations, for example, Cuba, China, Japan, we need no criminals, members of gangs, drug cartels, members of drug cartels. They want us to do that because our government does business and student visas. Businesses for these nations over here to do business with us. Students from their higher education to our higher education. Second aspect of the law is the law enforcement. When these people come over here, as I said, undocumented people, no criminals. When you got these unrest, riot, looting, destroying public, private property, going into people's homes, destroying people's safety, okay? They can't protect the law enforcement in these sanctuary cities, not protect us. America, we come first, and then these other criminals. The third and final aspect of why I believe should not is because of the fact of safety. There was just an innocent American of a 14-year-old and undocumented person, girl. She got raped in our school system. These are people, 14, 15, 16, 17 years old, with a mental capacity of a third grade education. They come to our school, no paperwork, what are those authorities supposed to do in school, facts supposed to do in school, safety. Now, while I believe that this should not be, this is the reality. I know my time's dropping off, I'll finish up here. It's because, one, this city, if it does become a sanctuary city, will lose its federal funding. That means no project for you, Mr. Mayor, at the city of funding. And second, the safety. This will be worse off than it already is. This city bad as it is already. You want to make change for a city? It's going to get a lot worse.
Thank you, Mr. Carraga.
See, people, this is the truth! No sanctuary!
That will not be allowed in this room.
I object to this meeting. I object to this mayor. I have been objecting for since he's been on council.
PD, this is related to the legislative agenda.
I don't need to be reminded, and if you'll check the films, every time I have gotten up, the president of this council has interrupted my time.
I'm Joy Hall, Schenectady. We need to have Schenectady as a sanctuary town. We are all going to work together. This is what Martin Luther King wanted. This is what my mother wanted. We can work together and get this thing solved. We're going to do it. We're going to stick with it. And do it and work together. And I work with the cops too, with them. So that's the way I want it.
I believe in sanctuary cities. I believe in from a law enforcement job perspective. I'm a seasonal NYRA peace officer, and I dealt with some incidents and with them that because you know I only know my culture. I only know what my soul is, and I'm influenced by others to try to change my opinion. And it's based on what believes and what pertains to me, because at the end of the day, that is only me that answers to myself. But I made some mistakes, and that's because I only knew certain things, but not everything. And that is when I had somebody from a different culture that responded in a way that I misinterpreted, and they corrected the situation where I could have convicted somebody or got them in trouble. And that's why I believe in cultural from a law enforcement deal. If we had more cultural environments in all aspects of business, we would have more less misinterpretation. To second, I want to mention about how these people come up, and you know they mean well, and they get all nerved up and ready from the other guy to talk and says, "Yo, I'm a taxpayer, and you guys work for me." And they have this mentality that they're going to tell you, "Oh, I'm not going to threaten you with not voting." Okay, you made your decision. It doesn't matter to me. Patience is a virtue. There's still time left. There's still more decisions to be made and more answers that need to be adjusted for a good answer that's harmonious with everybody. And I've seen for myself as a promoter, I participate in a lot of things. You got to participate, not rant. So I'm getting to the point. The thing is that our law enforcement has had basketball tournaments. They have involvement. They're interpersonal. There's a lot of programs. Look it up on YouTube. They're constantly involved with the community. People fear the uniform, and fake news tells how every cop is this bad guy. They're not. Judge the morals of the souls in the first 3 seconds that you talk to somebody, okay? Because that's what matters the most is that. I want to close with that, and I would like to say that, you know, every person, you know, deserves, a chance, and I'm done with my rant. Thank you.
As recently as 2 years ago, we received $300,000 for a camera installation in downtown. In 2008, $555,000 was awarded by Homeland Security to the county for development of the Homeland Security Consortium. Are we that financially flush that we can operate without these monies? Why in the world would we want to knowingly give up these funds in order to conduct an illegal activity? Sanctuary cities are illegal. To refuse to cooperate with federal authorities is walking into a landmine. Why would we want to subject ourselves to this? Proponents of sanctuary cities status will tell you that if we do not adopt to their thinking, we will be ripping families apart. Gang members are not the casual members of the illegal alien community we are told to tolerate. These are dangerous individuals who are following members of MS-13 into new areas of the country, especially into declared sanctuary cities. Once a month up at the Ancient Order of Hibernians, there's a swearing-in ceremony for new citizens. These people are from every corner of the globe who have come here, worked here, assimilated here, who take their oath of citizenship to the United States. It is one of the most moving ceremonies I have ever attended. Sanctuary city status would be a slap in the face to this process. Thank you.
It's probably 8 years now since I called the police about a theft in the backyard. I have called these police, I don't know how many times, more than seven, and they have yet to respond to any of my calls. And yet I keep getting grants for more equipment when they're making, some of them, well, they're the top overtime money makers in the council, and now they have to have new lockers. We pay for their time, their overtime, their vehicles, their laundry, and now they can't even live with the lockers they have or pay for their own lockers. What is so precious that they have to put in their lockers?
I was lucky enough to move to New York in 2004. In 2009, I chose to move my transracial, transethnic family to Schenectady. The reason I chose Schenectady is because of the diversity of our city. In particular, I wanted my kids in schools with people of mixed race, different gender identities, different sexual orientations. Schenectady offers all of those things. I especially value our community members from other countries, who I actually call friends. People from other countries, they offer us different perspectives. They offer us different languages. We get introduced to other cultures, food, which everyone likes. And most importantly to me, different ways of thinking and different ways of conceptualizing problems and solutions. I work as a social science researcher at SUNY Albany. Since 2013, I have been working on a study, leading a study, looking at social change strategies. I have interviewed several lifelong social activists, many who've done their activism work in Schenectady. Because of this study, I have access to hundreds of documents, starting in the 1940s to the present. These documents show a history of racial and ethnic and immigrant bias in our education system, in our labor force, and in our housing. Now, you know what else these documents show? They show your predecessors working with community organizers and activists to change laws. So I am asking you tonight to do what your predecessors have done to change the laws, to change the community and the feeling of the community, and to make Schenectady a sanctuary city.
I'm Benoit Bellevue. I'm sorry. Illegal is illegal. I don't care what anyone says. And now the governor wants to turn around and have lawyers take care of immigrants that are legal and illegal. Something's wrong someplace. I just can't understand what it is, illegal people. The first word out of the mouth is illegal. That's against the law. Secondly, I'm going to bring it up again. York Street Bridge. No one seems very much concerned about it. We signed the papers past fall. They said that the railroad was holding us up. It's 6 months now. What's holding us up now? In this last snowstorm we had, I know we're not going to get a big storm again. And I'm surprised you didn't catch this, Madam Chair. From Austerlitz to Gilliland Avenue on Helderberg Avenue, right on the corner of Gilliland Avenue, they didn't plow around the corner. Half that right-hand turn was covered. Traffic was tied up for a week. So, I mean, no one's paying attention about up in Bellevue, but we're paying attention about the casino. Thank you.
This mayor has presented, as far as I am concerned, a corrupt budget.
Being a sanctuary city does not mean applying public benefits to undocumented people, as some detractors would want us to believe. It means allowing law-abiding, undocumented residents to live among us peacefully without fear that they will be questioned by the Schenectady police officers about their immigration status. It will prevent Schenectady police officers from doing the work of federal immigration agencies to identify, apprehend, and detain law-abiding immigrants, documented or undocumented. It will give potentially vulnerable people more confidence to contact authorities to report crimes in our streets and community without fear of being turned over to federal authorities for possible deportation. Our nation is based on the contributions of immigrants of all races, creeds, and nationalities. Those living alongside us and contributing peacefully to our community should not live in fear of our police. Our police force has important work to do, and their mission should not be diluted by doing the work of federal agencies as well. I strongly urge and encourage all of you to continue the dialogue, to open up the dialogue for public discussion, and to consider making Schenectady a sanctuary city. Thank you.
So what I will say, being an attorney, is that I am trained to hone in on the problem. And what I see is the problem right now is that our elected officials are failing to conduct a public discussion about sanctuary cities. And I see that we have elected you, and you are choosing not to do that. And that may be a way for you to avoid a public conversation about a very obviously passionate and timely issue. But what I will say is that not discussing this issue is making a choice. And the choice has been made not to have the conversation, because as far as I can tell, there are only two council members willing to discuss this. So the assumption is that the remainder of the council members do not support a sanctuary city. And that will be noted in the public record with the lack of conversation. So everyone in this room is aware and knowing when they go back to the polls where their council members stand. Thank you.
I had someone wouldn't let me in my apartment for his dementia. He would not leave the front door. I couldn't get in. I checked with the chief of the fire department, and he said, in a case like that, if you want to pull the alarm on the fire alarm, we will respond to it and we will not charge you. And within 6 months, every single one of these fire alarms has been shut down, removed. They don't exist anymore.
My family and I have lived in the city since 1985. And as diverse as Schenectady was, it is even more so today. Schenectady is a beautifully woven fabric of multicultures, religions, colors, languages, genders, foods, stories, and more. Our city has welcomed people with open arms, giving a place to live without fear for themselves and their children. Schenectady has been a haven in the past, and we need Schenectady to be a safe place for everyone, including our immigrant citizens, to live as
people as president. This afternoon, he used two crimes, possibly the only two that they can document, of murder perpetrated by undocumented alien Mexicans. He focused on them to illustrate the kind of illegal immigrants the DOJ and ICE are seeking out to deport. Murderers, rapists, and dangerous criminals. But those are not the only undocumented people that ICE is targeting. Around the country, ICE is hanging out in courts, in hospitals, in schoolyards to detain decent people who have been here for years, even decades. Parents, husbands, wives, neighbors, friends, and family. I just want to read to you the ACLU response to Jeff Sessions that was posted on Facebook today. Despite the Trump, and I'm quoting, despite the Trump administration's bluster and threats, the federal government cannot force local police into becoming deportation agents and should not try to scare local authorities into taking illegal actions that undermine public safety and subject them to liability. Police and municipal officials have been sticking by their decisions to do what's best for the safety of their communities, and we will continue to stand with them in court to defend those awful choices. Thank you.
I did give you some extra time, but I need you to summarize.
Of course. I will honor your request. And I also request this gentleman not be filming men. Ever since I got caught, I caught them taking their show to Albany, doing parodies on me, and I reported it. They have accelerated from the proctor their activities on me.
Thank
it
you,
has
Morris.
Been accelerated.
Wow.
So many cities and other cities started developing, came up with this idea. It will be safer for the city. The city will work better if we don't, the immigrants, illegal immigrants, aren't afraid that our local policemen will send them off to the immigration service. Illegal immigrants, we want to talk about, people have made some excellent points. We're talking law-abiding citizens, not known criminals who come in here, known criminals get arrested. There have been a few cases that have been glory, that made big issues of. There was a famous case in San Francisco. You get people afraid of illegal immigrants. Oh my God, I don't want that kind of person coming in and tearing apart my community. We're talking like one individual or two. There's lots of other criminals around here too. We're not going to get rid of every white male because of a white male who killed people, right? So we have to be careful about overreacting to things being presented in a way that strikes at our fears and racism. Why do they need to offer grant money? If it's a bad idea for cities to become sanctuary cities, why do they need to have to offer money to say don't become a sanctuary city? If it was obvious that the right thing to do is not become a sanctuary city, they can just make the case. This is bribe money. We're trying to get you to take the money. And now I want you to stop and think, at what case would you not take the money? Right? At what point is it, would you take money that will make your city worse? So if you examine the sanctuary city status and then recognize, hey, this might work pretty well, you should come to the conclusion, well, this is right regardless of what the federal government's going to do. I don't want your money, federal government, if it's going to make me do something that's going to make my city a less livable and less likable place. Thank you.
This, I look around here, there's a whole lot more women than there are men. And is this what women are supposed to do with their lives? I see this whole thing as a bunch of sour grapes, people that didn't get their way. I mean, everybody knows how New York State voted, and all the candidates were from New York State. This council, you sit here, you will not answer our questions like every other, unlike every other community in this county that gets aired on television. You will not answer us. You have abandoned us. You get your check. Most of you are double dippers. Some of you are even triple dippers. You have abandoned us. I have not found a war that this community has not been willing to reenact. It goes on and on and on.
Item 18, Street Improvement Program. I have two questions. Who owns the shoulders of the roads? And why isn't the word shoulders included in the language for the contract? Last year, the city blacktopped my street. The shoulders were not done. Cars park on the shoulders. Why aren't the shoulders considered part of street improvement? The same thing happens on other streets. The street gets paved, the shoulders do not. How does this approach fit into street improvement? Item 13, restoring the tax exempt status to the Unitarian Church and Hindu temple. Information released by the Deputy Council's office states that these religious organizations lost their tax exempt status due to administrative oversight. Where were Mr. Buda Baron and Ms. Porterfield? It happened on their watch. I question question the foreclosure list at the time. Why didn't they? These church communities went through a lot of needless grief because council members were not paying attention. It was incompetence of the worst kind. Now they want to come back for another 4 years. I hope the church members remember on election day. Thank you.
Jess, you work at what barbershop?
Wedgeway Barbershop.
Right next door to this building?
Yes.
How long have you worked there?
I've worked there for 1 year, but I had also worked there back in the 90s for 11 years. I left and had my own shop for a while, and then I came back again.
Gotcha. You're a Schenectady guy?
Yes, I am. Yes.
Remember growing up, seeing this building here?
Yes, I do. It's very historical, interesting architect. It's too bad it had to come down. I mostly remember it when it was Maurice's. It was like a soup and sandwich place, but earlier it was a German restaurant back in the olden days, the 50s and 60s. I'm a little too young to remember that. We didn't live in the area then.
Yeah. Were you bummed to see it come to this?
Oh, sure I am. You know, but, you know, as working in the Wedgeway Barbershop every day, customers would ask us about the Nicklaus building, and, you know, we had no answers other than what was in the paper. The owners are fighting with the city's fighting with the owners, etc. And it's too bad it couldn't be salvaged, but it's, you know, it's interesting how they don't waste any time doing the emergency demolition.
Yeah, it came down pretty quickly overnight. When you got here this morning, were you a little shocked to see, wow, it's already done?
No, I knew it was going to happen because I was here with my own cameras. I do JP News for Open Stage Media. And I was hoping to get some of the wrecking, but it started to get too cold, rainy, windy. I was worried about my camera getting wet and stuff, so I retreated and went back home, but when I watched the news right before going to bed, I saw that they had already tore down a portion of it.
Now, this came down for safety reasons.
That's right.
But do you wish it could have been prevented? Do you wish something else could have been done?
Well, yeah, I do wish something else could have been done, but I would say it's probably about 10 months too late to, you know, to fix anything.
Are you upset that it's down, or are you okay with it, or?
Oh, it's something that I'll get over with. It is, you know, kind of a disappointment, you know.
Sure. Yeah, some people we talk to are pretty torn up about it.
Yeah, I think the same way about it as everybody else does. Yeah.
Yeah. Cool. Well, that's all we need. Thanks, Jess. Appreciate
right.
your time.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks for